Now item three, I believe.
Yes, commissioners, this is a request for the appointment of the employee's representative for the Forsyth County Board of Ethics. Nominations were accepted from all full-time employees through May 4th. Two nominations were tendered. One nomination accepted and another nominee declined. The incumbent, Dr. Rickettson, had chosen not to renew his term. That resulted in a single candidate being nominated as the employee representative. As such, the employee vote for a single nominee did not occur, and they are declared the winner. Therefore, the full-time employees are requesting that the Board of Commissioners appoint Mr. Charles Laughinghouse as a nominee for the position for the employee representative for a two-year term that would begin July 1st, 2012 and run through June 30th, 2014.
Pat, when was the announcement made to the employees?
It was announced, I believe, you mean for the nominees?
Right. Wasn't it April 27th that went out to the employees?
That sounds about right. I don't know the exact date.
And they were taken through May 4th?
Yes.
Which was 7 days. But according to the Ethics Code, Section 2.11.12a, Kenneth can check me on this, that the employees are supposed to be given 30 days to submit nominations, and they were only given 7. So I'm going to make a motion to send this back to the employees.
Let me check that.
Do you say who the other person was? Are you allowed to say that out loud?
I don't. Absolutely.
Was rejected.
Oh,
okay.
I don't.
And for what reason?
He chose not
to. No, but you said there were two people.
No, one chose not to do it.
One chose not to do it.
Yeah,
sorry.
He didn't accept the
nomination.
Yeah.
But the ethics ordinance says that they have 30 days, which then the county manager is supposed to notify the Board of Commissioners within 5 days. And then, in all reality, it then goes to the next regular meeting of the Board of Commissioners, not a work session.
Well, we better follow the work.
So we need to follow the ordinance. So therefore, I make a motion that we send it back to the employees to reopen nominations for an additional 23 days.
Let's just wait for him to verify.
So is it the case that the appointment or the nomination process was not open for 30 days?
7.
It was open for 1 week, for about 7 days.
It was opened on the 27th and closed on the 4th.
I believe it was. She has gone the Tuesday.
Well, I mean, Section 2.11.12a does say that the body or individuals notified shall have 30 days in which to conduct their appointment process and provide the county manager with the name of their appointment.
Does that also hold true for all nominees?
Well, what it says, that has to do with the initial appointment process. But then it says in B that all appointments following the expiration of the initial term
shall
proceed as set forth in Section A, which is the initial process. So it would seem to wrap back up into it again. So it would appear that a 30-day open nomination process appears to be accurate.
The last thing we want to do is not follow that.
Yeah.
We've got to
ethics.
Oh, I agree.
We need to start over, just scrap it and reopen them for 30 days.
Would the 30 days start from the beginning, or do you use that first week?
Well, if we're going to start the process over again, it would probably make sense just to start it, yeah.
Okay.
For both the elected officials and the employees, then, because they were both already open.
And that, for the record, is the item for the elected officials and the employee representative.
I
And then, okay.
Ken, do you have anything further to add to that?
That appears accurate, Mr. Chairman.
So then they need to do that, and then they have to notify the Board of Commissioners within 5 days of who has been elected.
Yeah, and I will tell you, I'm not concerned about it being in a regular meeting, because anything we do here has to go to the regular meeting to be approved anyway. So I don't mind the nominees being discussed here, but it's going to have to be approved down.
Has to be approved at regular.
That's correct.
But it doesn't have to come to a work session.
It doesn't have to, it just says that the board shall.
It can go directly to a regular meeting.
At the regular meeting, might as well go and put it on a regular meeting.
Okay.
Definitely.
Do we need a vote or anything?
I don't know, is that a motion or?
You know, for the record, I would prefer just a motion to basically reinstitute the process.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion, we not accept the employee representative Charlie Backinghouse or the elected representative, elected official representative. And because they were, feel that is because they were elections, nominations not up long enough, and that we send it back to the Ethics Board to start the process.
Let me ask you this question, just, and I know you got to make a second. Would it be appropriate, though, given that those nominations did occur during what was believed to be the, that they'd be put back into the pool?
I think whoever nominated them can just put them back in again. I would think that we have to conduct it accordingly. It has to be over 30 days.
Hold on a minute. I don't know why we necessarily have to start the entire cycle over. The 30 days is still running, is it not?
Well, no, I'm comfortable with starting the process over again.
I think we'll start the process over again.
Then I agree.
Yeah, so they can renominate the people.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Todd's not. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Ben absent. For items 3 and 4 together, and now we're on to number 5.
Mr. Chairman, I need to apologize to the board, but I need us to revisit items 3 and 4, and I'll tell you why. You all asked me a question during that discussion about the 30-day process, and I believe I gave you an opinion, having pulled up the ethics ordinance, that there was 30 days for the nominating process. And I feel like that if upon further review, and I'm sitting here staring at it and had time to digest the full paragraph, if I feel like I've gotten it wrong, I need to tell you. So let me tell you why I'm saying what I'm saying. The language says that the group of individuals shall have 30 days in which to conduct their appointment process. My problem is, and speaking with Pat, I know we only got one nomination, for instance, with respect to the employees, but that would typically have involved a vote. So if we're supposed to nominate and vote within 30 days, that's the process, then I think it's, to me, that means it's pretty clear that the nomination process is going to be less than 30. Does that make sense? Because there's supposed to be a nomination and a vote all within 30 days, and we bring the results to you. And I apologize that I messed that up when I just.
How long do we think we need for the election now?
This is a time to define that, because you can't have a one-day nominating period and then close it.
I don't disagree with that.
And then 29 days, you know, or somebody's going to have
a fit. Absolutely. I think that we need to revisit the ordinance and just put this on hold until we can revise the ordinance.
There's no grounds for revising.
There's grounds.
Not when they've made a recommendation.
It's confusing.
Yes, it is confusing.
They apparently weren't confused by that.
Well, I think they were.
I don't know. They were able to.
And as the governing body.
Well, it took Ken 2 times.
Yeah. And he probably right.
He just paid not to be confused.
That thing was on a hiatus for how long with that ethics ordinance against them? It's not going to hurt them to take time to get it right. So I would make a motion that we review the ethics ordinance at the next work session. So if we need to clarify, we do so. And I hope it would require public hearings and then go back and have the elections accordingly.
I might like to just interject that all previous nomination processes have followed the same process that we have. Not that it says that the previous ones were right, but it does follow the same exact methodology.
That's what we had wrong before.
And interpretation of the ethics ordinance.
I think we had it wrong before, and I think we need to get it right.
All right.
Are we voting again or reconsidering or what?
Well, the motion was to basically reject the nominations and start the process over again.
I think that we need to rescind those and then make a motion to address the ordinance confusion and get it cleared up before we do it again.
Well, if you want to do that, we need to go ahead and make a motion for reconsideration of the previous items.
Can we move my second?
Does it go to public hearing then?
It well, that's we'll get to that. Let's make the motion for reconsideration first.
I'd like to first make a motion, Counselor, if you don't mind, as a separate issue, that we, at the next work session, have you bring back language that's clear, that lays out very clear steps for nominations and elections, notifications, etc. And that we get that right. I'd like to make that motion first, which I think I can. So that would be my motion.
Well, I'm just going to go ahead and say this then. I am uncomfortable with us. The agenda item is simply the ratification of these two issues. I am sorry. I got it wrong. I did. I mean, it seems to me that it's a 30-day process, not a 30-day nomination window. But what I have heard in the interim is that this is how we've done it for years. And, you know,
yeah, but if we've done it wrong for years, Counselor, with all due respect, I think you're hearing the board say we want to get it right. I think that's what you're hearing down here.
Well, that's fine. I don't know that it's wrong. Is my problem.
It's confusing.
It's confusing. And I'm not prepared to appoint somebody to a board as important as the ethics board, not knowing if we're following the ethics ordinance to set the ethics board. I think that it's difficult for us to assume that we have it right and perhaps face an ethics complaint that we're not following the ethics ordinance.
I have a suggestion. Maybe we just postpone 3 or 4 and then in the interim direct you to bring this to a public hearing. Then we're not voting down.
When do the present individuals leave?
Well, their term would cease June 30th. Okay. Of this year, 2012.
Okay. We have some time.
I think we have some time to get it right. And so I think that we need to bring it to the next work session. I've just asked Cindy if you could just have them, if somebody's okay with it, then we'll put it on the next work session to review those portions of the ethics ordinance. I asked Ken to have something prepared for that work session that is very, very clear on what that is.
Well, are we reconsidering this or not?
Do we need to rescind our motion on 3 and 4 first?
We don't. I'm not comfortable, Counselor, if you just want me to say it out loud, rescinding these until we have the other stuff corrected. Because on top of having concerns about the process being followed, I hate to say it publicly, I have some concerns about the individual that's been appointed because he's involved with potential litigation on a very issue that I don't think he should be appointed.
And I'm not trying to get into that. I really am not. I made a call earlier that it was a 30-day nominating process. I'm telling you, I don't read it that way now. And I'm apologizing for the fact that I gave you bad advice.
So I think we need to set this issue get straight and then we'll postpone this.
But I'm also telling you that my HR director is saying this is the process we followed historically. This is the process that's in the ordinance. If you all want to revisit it, I will revisit it. I'm uncomfortable, though, if we're not going to ratify what the process has produced.
I don't think we can ratify something if we believe it's in conflict with the ordinance or not clear. How do you expect the board to ratify something when we don't know? Just because it's been done before doesn't mean that it's been done correctly.
I'd like to make a motion to reconsider items 3 and 4.
I think we had a motion. Are we going to put it? How are we doing the other issue? gone on the next work session?
Right now it is, yes. You've given direction for me to bring back language to the next work session on the ordinance.
Is that an outstanding motion?
No, no.
No, that wasn't a motion at all, that was just direction.
I just wanted to make sure there wasn't a motion.
All right, well, I'll go back.
A motion to reconsider both items?
Yes.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign, I believe that passes.
And board members, again, I apologize.
I'd like to make a motion that we postpone item number 3 and 4 until we get the ethics ordinance resolved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign, aye. And that passes 3-1 with Commissioner Levent being absent. All right. Sign ordinance, number 8.
Ken, sorry about that mix-up. I know it's confusing sometimes.